Women attacked, raped, shot, some left for dead. Cleveland has a serial rapist.
This, like many cases that we all face throughout our career, we need the public's help. And this is one of those cases.
Here's a case. One man linked to multiple rapes dating back to 1996. I want to bring in Special Agent Vicki Anderson with the FBI in Cleveland. Agent Anderson, we're talking here. I know the first rape happened in 96, the most recent rape in 2010. DNA, all links to the same guy. And all these attacks, from what I understand, they're happening within about a half-mile radius. So I guess my question is, we still don't know who this guy is?
That's correct. We have reached out to the public and are asking for the public's assistance in trying to help us identify this individual. We do have DNA linkage to all of these crimes, the four rapes, and one of those actually resulted in a homicide. So we are asking the public to take a look at the sketches that we have. We have one from 1996 and another from 2010. That's a pretty good depiction, according to the victims, of this individual. So we're asking the public to take a look at the sketch, and if they have any ideas, anyone that meets these characteristics, to please call us at 1-800-CALL-FBI and report that information.
We've got both sketches up here on the screen, so let's just keep those up, guys. And I know police, okay, they announced some clues about this guy. They're using to track him down. It sounds like they have a lot to go on. Take a listen.
This male was smoking wet, which is marijuana laced with PCP. He was listening to reggae music. The auto he was in was either a Buick Regal or a Monte Carlo, white in color.
So they knew his car, this type of music, the drug of choice, this stuff called wet. He has some sort of very descriptive, unique scar on his face. Is that at all helping here as far as, you know, searching for this guy?
We're hoping so, and that's our reason for getting this out. Cleveland Police Department has been working on this case tirelessly. They have tracked down every lead that has obviously come their way, and they reached out to the FBI and said, you know, can you guys just help us get this out? So, of course, we always reach out and help our local law enforcement when we can and when they ask. So that is what we did here, and we're just asking for the public to take a look at this. I mean, an individual with a large scar on his face, 2.5 inches on his cheek, according to the victims, you would think is pretty recognizable. So we're asking, you know, if you know someone that has that type of scar, you know, the reggae music taste may have changed over the years. It was important in 1996, but maybe he's changed his type of music. So we don't want people to hesitate, you know, on, well, he doesn't listen to reggae music, but he does have a scar. I better not call. Go ahead and call. We take any report, any tip seriously, and we'll follow that tip.
What else are you doing?
Until we track it down.
What else are you doing other than getting the sketches out, pleading to the public for help? What else?
Yes, we have put this on FBI radio, our FBI Twitter account, our FBI Facebook account. It's on the Cleveland Police Department website. It's on the Cleveland FBI website. Of course, all of our local TV stations covered this yesterday and continue to cover it today. We have various, you know, knock and talk operations that we do as a task force in Cleveland that involve local, state, and federal going out to, you know, try to get information when people are reluctant to come to the police. We go out to them, and when we do those operations, we take this photograph with us.
Sure, sure.
And we ask people, you know, in those areas, if you have any information, to please give us a call.
Sure, and the fact, the news, even though this happened, you know, beginning back in the 90s, the fact that now you know this is one guy because the DNA links them all, let us know if you find him. Vicki Anderson, best of luck. Thank you.